We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Good morning, friends. Today we start our new lectures in the subject of experimental techniques and instrumentation in thermal engineering, which is the subject for the ME Thermal Engineering Semester 1. Myself, Patel Jignes, Assistant Professor in Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari. Now, in this subject, we have one of the module, which is the Advanced Measurement Technique and Analysis, which is in this chapter, we have some of the subtopic, which is the gas analyzers. So today we are discussing the gas analyzer. Actually, this is the gas analyzer is application for the thermal power plant, whether or some of the combustion process which can be taken place over there. So whenever the combustion can be take place, at that time the flue gases will be generated. So that flue gases can be analyzed, and then after we have to optimize the process. So basically it's a very important thing for that. So we can discuss what is the gas analyzer, how it can be works. So now we see start the lecture, gas analyzer. Now this one is the one out of part for the analyze the gas. So this one is the ORSA type gas analyzer. So different kind of gas analyzer will be available nowadays, but today we have to discuss about the ORSA apparatus, how it can be worked. You can see that this one is the first part in this ORSA apparatus. We can see that this one is the flue gases. Now first of all, first question arises, what is the flue gases? We are just taking the combustion engine as an example. We are getting the some exhaust. We getting the some exhaust. At a similar way, when we are producing the in a boiler, we are just taking the one another example, boiler, in which we are producing the by combustion of the fuel, we are getting the some conversion of the this fuel. After combustion this fuel, it's generating some gases, those gases which is called flue gases. Now this flue gases has a some contained like CO2, CO, N2, O2, these are the contaminant will be heaven in the flue gases. So fundamentally, how much amount of the CO, CO2, O2 and N2 in this flue gases we have to analyze, and from this analyze results we have to predict the process. If I am just telling that whenever we have to getting the some exhaust gases, in that cases exhaust gases has some contaminant. If we can see that if it's not properly combustioned take place, so it has a larger content of the CO. When it completely combustion take place, it has a larger amount of CO2. Also whenever it has a excess amount of the O2, so we can say that it's a larger amount of oxygen can be provided. So ultimately, by means of getting the analyzations and analyze results, we predict or optimize the process. So first one is the flue gases. Now this can be passing through this U-shape, in which we have to contain the few COCl2. Now this has a 3 bulb over there, which can be operated by this valve, and it has a 3-way stop valve. So it can be whenever flue gases will be supplied, this valve can be operated. Now what will happen after that, passing through the straight tubes, it can be passing to the graduated burette, and it can be contained by the some water sealed over there. So this one is the water seal, which can be provided over there, surrounded to the buret, and further it can be connected with a larger reservoir. At that moment they are just providing the bottle, but it's a larger reservoir which can be continuously provide the water flow, or we can say that color water will be, we have to get in there. Now what will happen actually, how it can be, or so apparatus can be worked. So this 3 beam can be one kind of absorber where this content KOH solution will be provided, pyrological pyrogallic acid will be there, liquid NH plus CO2Cl2 will be there. So these are the absorbent where we are getting the value, or we can absorb the some gases. Now what will happen when we have to operate this valve, what will happen, we have to open this stopcock valve and flue gases will be enter over there. So after that it can be come over there and it can be passing through this graduated buret. What will happen, this stopcock valve will be closed, the three-way stopcock valve will be closed. After that what will happen, by using of this reservoir we have to increasing the amount of water in this buret. So what will happen, graduated buret we have to already, we can measuring this KOH solution, pyrogallic acid and liquid NH3 plus CO2Cl2 mass will be already measured. So this one is the known value. Now what will happen when this level can be raised, your flue gases can be traveled from this one to this side. So at that cases this first valve will be open and this KOH solutions which will be absorbed these gases, and in this they have to absorb only value of CO. It can be absorbed the value of CO, how much amount of the CO will be absorbed. Then after remaining fluid which can be, valve can be opened, so it can be again, it can be passing through the this graduated buret. Again this valve will be closed, and after that it can be again, water level can be increased. So what will happen, again it can be, now valve will be closed and this valve will be open. So what will happen, this flue gases can be traveled from this one, and at that case is pyrogallic acid which can be absorbed a value of O2. And further whenever the third valve, similarly it can be operated, this valve will be open and this graduated buret can be, amount of water will be arise, and that again it can be flow this liquid liquid ammonia cuprous chloride, in which they have to absorb the value of CO2. CO2 can be absorbed over there. Now this is the already known value, so amount of the mass can be added over there. So from that we can getting that how much amount of the CO2 in this, whatever we am getting the amount of the flue gases, in which how much amount of the CO, how much amount the O2 and how much amount of CO2 remaining one, we can getting the value of also nitrogen. So we can see that where the your flue gas is not properly combustion, at that time amount of the CO will be rise. When it has a more oxygen, so O2 value will be getting more, and also when it's a properly combustion, at that time we are getting the value of CO2. So this one is the Orsatt apparatus when we are getting the actually analyze the how much amount of the mass, or we can say that how much amount of the CO, CO2 and O2 or N2 in this whole flue gases composition. So this one is the Orsatt gas analyzer when we are using the analyze the gas. Thank you for watching. These are the some references over there. Thank you for watching.